Hello everybody, welcome to Let's Play Dark Souls 3 with the bow only. I'm Nospio, and this is going to be a 100% run of Dark Souls 3. We're going to kill as much stuff as we can. I'm going to fight every boss along the way, and doing so only with the bow. This is our character here, crawling out of the grave. So, I've set a few rules for this run. There's no melee weapons allowed. Probably going to sell all the weapons that we get just for souls to buy more arrows and more upgrades for our bows. If I ever do use a crossbow or an item, it'll only be for PvP, so only to survive an invasion. I'm just going to equip the short bow only right now, and we're going to go find our bandit knife, leave that, leave our iron shield, and we're never going to see those again, so let's wave goodbye, and off we go. So, I'm not going to shoot anything in the tutorial area here, because we only have 30 arrows, and until we actually get past the first boss, there's no way to get more arrows. So we have to save everything we can. So we're going to pick up the items along the way, though, because definitely want to grab the treasures while we're here. But we are, another rule for this run, we're going to allow buff magic. So things that will improve the damage or ability to evade things, or maybe even iron flesh might be useful at some points. So we'll be picking up those and leveling up for those, but no offensive magic, nothing that's going to deal damage by itself or cause us to deal damage without actually firing our bow. So everything's about using the bow in this run. There's definitely going to be some major challenges along the way. Some bosses will just be ridiculous, some enemies as well. I'm going to try to do my best to kill at least one of everything I can find so that we're not just like skipping out on enemies and making this a speed run with the bow where we just run directly to all the bosses and kill them while skipping hard bosses. Like probably the giant tree will be a big pain in the butt. Not going to say anything more about it, but that thing might be a big pain in the butt. Anyways, here we are at the first bonfire. I have a couple items to pick up here. We're going to circle back around rest of the bonfire and then head down to Mr. Gundyr down there. So here's our first item, it's a Titanite Shard, which is going to be extremely useful because we're only going to get so many weapons in this game, so we need them to be as strong as they can. And the sooner that they are, the better. I'm picking up the firebombs here just as absolute backup in case of a PvP situation early on, because I don't really want to spend my souls on firebombs if I can avoid it. At this point, anyways, I'm definitely going to be loading up on everything just in case. Because as much as I'd love to do all the invasions with PvP too, I feel like I should at least bring something to make those fights at least entertaining. Because if I just use the bow, it'll probably just go horribly until I have a few bows that are pretty strong. But you can be tricky with a crossbow and items, so see how that goes. Anyways, we're almost at the boss. And we made it past everything, just going to make sure we don't get hit by a arrow in the back here. And I have done a couple practices of this fight, so hopefully it'll go as I practiced. Here we go. Bow only, nothing else. Oh, see, there's that wild arrow that we just avoided. Get a couple shots in here. Get that really close last frame dodge there, it feels like. So the reason I'm using the bow in the left hand is I tried having the bow in the right hand because I initially thought I might have been able to parry with the bow in the right hand, but turns out you can't. You'll just do attacks. So personal preference for me, because I'm right-handed, is to just feels natural to have the bow in the left hand. Just makes sense to me. But you can already see that Gundyr over here is turning into a pincushion. He's got arrows everywhere. Missed one shot there. Every shot counts. Missing a shot actually does hurt. Alright, let's dodge that. Oh, missed two shots, that's not good. He's gonna transform soon. It's a good time to lay in some good damage. There he goes. But we also gotta start being a little bit more careful. Oh, I was just about to say, we haven't been hit yet, and then we take two massive hits right there. It's gonna be a snake bite kind of thing. Heal up here. There's a few attacks from my experience that you want to be a little bit extra careful with. That's... No, that's not one of them. That one's not too bad. That's the dangerous one right there. That second sweep. When he does that... Oh, jeez, that's 3 missed arrows. That's not good. We have 9 left. And I took another hit. 9 should be able to take down his health, though. It should be enough arrows. If I don't miss any more, we should be okay. Get another one in there. Some of the times when he's doing this like slight strafe walk, he can move just fast enough at the certain angles to dodge your attack. So I like to be a little bit extra careful. That one did extra damage. Oh shoot. Oh, I think I was too close to get hit by that one that time. Holy smokes. Alright, we got 2 arrows left. We should be able to get him here. And there we go. Oh, 1 arrow remaining. I think the most I ever had in a practice run was 4. I think you could probably get him with 5 remaining, but... there we go. First boss down. So let's mosey on to the next area. We got 3,000 souls there. So that's going to be enough to get at least a bow upgrade and stock up on quite a few arrows. We're going to want to carry as much arrows as we can because... with no melee weapon allowed, we're going to have to make our way through most areas just with the bow. Well, I mean, obviously just with the bow. So, if there's things we need to fight, we don't want to run out of arrows partway through. And just realizing now that since we're not going to fight a whole lot of little enemies like that in certain areas, we've got to get good at... Of course we have to get good, but we have to get good at maneuvering around enemies on... run backs from items like that. I don't know if I should attempt to take on the Swordmaster here. I'm gonna take that and wake those guys up though. Let's see. Will this guy happen to just jump down here? Can I do the cheesy way? Nope, not close enough. Let's just run. Let's just run for it. I don't wanna die right there. We will come back for that guy though. At some point. I don't know if we'll do it right away. But we will. Well, it seems like one of those other guys just fell off the edge there, because we got 40 souls. Just picking up the treasures located around the Firelink Shrine here. And there is a dog over here, but we're not going to kill him, because we only got 1 arrow. So even if we tried, he probably wouldn't die unless we managed to like launch him off the edge. There we go. Made it to the Firelink Shrine. And we'll talk to a friend here. This guy. I think he gives us a emote early on. We're just gonna skip through the stuff. We're not really gonna do much of a story let's play, we're just doing it for the bow. That's all we're here for. So let's level up. We're gonna invest in dexterity right off the bat because that gives us enough to use the longbow that we're gonna get soon. I don't know if we need 10 strength for it. I'm gonna gamble and say no. We can always come back. Should I do that? No, not yet. Let's just get the... Nope, don't cancel. Let's just get the dexterity for the longbow, and then we'll go from there. But let's go upgrade our short bow right away. Because the way I see it, they both have different abilities. We're just going to have them both maxed out if we can. I am going to spam his talk just to get the emote, though. There we go, get the hurrah. And we can allot our Estus all to health right now, because... We won't be using the special ability just yet, which the bow we have does... Oh, we need 2. It does have a cool one. You can do some rapid shots. It's pretty nice. Pretty fun. Stock up on arrows, and that's the best thing to do. Let's get some couple of these, or grab that anyway, for getting ourselves some into places, because it could be cool to help some people out with the arrow only. And let's just get a whole bunch of wood arrows, since they're not too bad. Let's spend 1,000 souls on arrows. That seems fair. 200 arrows? Alright. Does that seem alright? Maybe we should get more. Yeah, we can't do anything else right now, so let's just get all arrows. And head on into the next area. I don't think there's anything else to do in here, so let's light the bonfire up. And I always felt like this place got a little bit more bright and shiny when you light the bonfire. Could just be my imagination though. So let's head to the High Wall of Lothric. Let's see what it's like to adventure through our first real area with just the bow alone. And like I said, we're gonna pick up a whole bunch of treasures along the way, but we're just gonna sell most of them or turn them into things. So here's the door, and yeah. So I hope you guys are excited for this run. I certainly am. I've been thinking about it a whole bunch. Really looking forward to recording it this weekend. And we're not gonna go that way. There's a thing over there we want to get, but I want to wait until we have probably fire arrows before I go over that way. So let's take on our first guy here. Doink. The bows do have, well, it's kind of a trade right there, a unique trait in that you can aim them, which I think is awesome. If you can aim them, oh my lord, this is just terrible. But another cool thing they have is like special attacks like that. Now you can do rolling shots, you can do backstep shots, and I think that's awesome. I think that adds a whole new dynamic to the way that you can play with the bow. Obviously it does less damage than just a regular shot, but I think it just allows you to get that little bit more damage in when you otherwise wouldn't. And there still is headshots, if you can land them. There we go, see? That guy went down in one shot, and all I had to do was aim it. There's certain places in the game where I think the bow will actually make the game easier than playing with a melee weapon. Like, if I can do it, and take this guy out in the face, come on. There we go. Took that guy out, and then do a backstep shot, rolling shot, and rolling shot, and that was absolutely no problem at all. So, get the binoculars here, which we kind of won't need. I mean, maybe if we want to line up like a really cool shot later on. There are a few places, like I want to see if you can shoot the giant on the tower later in the game with a bow from far away and have like an archer battle. That would be really cool. I kind of doubt that, but we'll see. For my starting bonus item, I picked the rusted coins, because I like to use them to get additional item find, which I don't think there's a whole lot of things we might be looking for, but maybe there is. I haven't played through all of this game. I've made it up to Aldric, didn't defeat Aldric, and now we're doing this. So there's going to be a lot of the game I haven't even seen yet, which, I mean, if it's not possible to do a bow run, we'll find out as we go. But I think if you're dedicated enough, you can probably do it. And that was kind of boring and lame. I should probably just skip shield guys from now on, because they take a lot of time and a lot of arrows. And we're already down to 64, so let's heal up. There is an arrow guy here. We're going to skip him, because there's a big old nasty dragon that flies right there. Take the ember. Dodge our way through, for the most part. Anybody following us? The guy wants to. This guy is. There we go. Take this guy out too. Just do a quick shot. There we go. See if I can make this jump here. Alright. There's a unfriendly treasure chest down there we'll deal with later on. But that's all that's in that tower. And so this guy... How many arrows? I have 60 arrows. Do I want to deal with him just yet? I'll go get my arrows stocked up, and then we'll come back and see about fighting that guy. Because like I said, I want to try and fight at least one of everything in the game, even if I skip it later on. This way we can see if there's certain things that are just really dangerous for the bow, and really difficult to deal with, or if certain enemies are just handleable. Like this guy with the shield, he's kind of a pain in the butt. That dude... probably gonna be even worse. So this guy's kind of giving me a headache right now. Not really. Let's just run by, because we already fought a shield guy. We know it's a pain in the butt, and we're just gonna ignore him. He's got a whole bunch of arrows in his shield. He can deal with it. So here we are. Next bonfire. There might be a Titanite shard around the corner there. The bonfire kind of lit up. I think there's an enemy too close for us to rest. And it's this guy. Jeez, man. Can you just go away? There we go. Doing rolling shots and stuff seems to work if you can bait those guys into attacking. It's good to know. So there we go, got 99 arrows again. It's nice that the game restocks it automatically for you. And got another Titanite shard. So we have a choice to either go and upgrade the short bow or the long bow when we go pick it up at the other area. But let's kill this thief, not that guy. I want to kill this guy first. Do a quick shot. Oh, messed up the back step, but that's okay. Still alive. Alright, let's get a shot in the back. Start this fight off right. Two shots. Now the trick is when you're trying to do maximum damage off your things and you're safe enough is to roll and then wait just a tick so that you can do a regular shot instead of a quick shot. He's two-handing now, that's perfect for us. As long as he doesn't have a shield, we're happy. Because we're just relying entirely on dodging. The rolling backstep, or the rolling shot does take you forward just a step though. So you have to be a little bit careful. Same with the backstep. Ooh, we need to be really careful here. Drop a heal. There we go, wait for him to do the second swing, and then get it. Oh, got it. Alright, another pincushion, and we get a crossbow. Man, the game is just like, you know what? You're going to need this when you get invaded pretty soon. We don't have any bolts yet, so I won't even bother equipping it. We have some more items over here to help us when we inevitably get invaded. So let's see, can we get this thief? Oh, we're going to have to fight him up here. Come on, bud. Right in the face. Whoop. There you go. There's one more right there, so let's get a snipe shot on him. There we go. I think we hit him in the face, I'm not sure. We want to go this way first. I'm just going to take all the paths that I think are the best, and we will come back to the other paths. Can we knock this guy off? I don't think so. I think we're going to have to fight him. Or actually, you know what? You know what, I only got 76 arrows, and I already fought you kind of guys, so we're moving on. We are going to grab the upgrade gems, even though we're not really going to have them in anything to use them on. No, there's nothing really for us to use them on at all. Actually, can we even kill them? I'm not even going to bother, never mind. I'll do those one day when I'm just gathering materials before a new game plus or something like that. But we do have black fire bombs over here. Definitely going to want those to use against invaders since we're not going to use them on regular enemies. Alright. Let's do this. Let's let you shoot first. Come on. I'll dodge. Oh, nope, that didn't. Oh, I should heal. I'm just going to try this and see if it works. Dodge. Nope. Alright, screw it. Just take him out. Is there an item over there? There is. Alright, we got to go get it then. I just gotta shoot a little bit faster. Can we shoot this guy's hands? Try a little bit harder. Come on. Come on. Come on. Nope. Alright, what if he starts to stand up? Nope. Can't do it. Well, you probably can, I just should have manually aimed. Make a quick shot on that guy. Another shot on this guy. Man, that sucks to have to use an arrow when he has like just barely a tick of health left. Oh well. Firebombs, we're going to be overstocked on those pretty soon. Which is not a bad thing. We got a whole bunch of dudes in here. This is going to be a rough room. Normally this room's not too bad when I come through here with a nice weapon. Oh, we actually shot through the stairs there. That was cool. Alright, that wasn't actually nearly as bad as I thought it would be. The guy was going for a backstab on us. Jerk. There we go. Probably didn't have to do all quick shots, but felt like being fancy, so we did all quick shots. There's a treasure here. We're going to go for it. Shoot him right in the head. Boop. Boop. There we go. And Undead Hunter Charm. That might help when we get invaded. Oh man, we're all out of everything. I'm just going to rearrange my inventory while I wait for the night here. Just in case we get invaded. Which I don't think will happen in this area, but we have to fight this guy, so 46 arrows, here we go. He's not using his shield too much, which is nice for me. When I have a melee weapon, I usually just have a lot of difficulty with this guy anyway. And I usually just run by. Man, he's being brutal with that shield. Oh, get that shot in. Might as well. Yeah, we don't have any Estus either. This is going to be rough. Especially since he does those like shield jabs. Gotta watch out for when he goes two-handed too. Oh man, this is just oh shoot. Like I thought when he went two-handed that would be good for me, but he did such a nasty charge. Alright. When we're far away, he seems to drop his guard a little bit. Like he's just letting me put arrows in him right now. Like that went from like really horrendous to not bad pretty quickly. Shot in. Alright, might be able to get him here. Nope. Drop the guard. Oh, come on, dude. Come on. I don't want to keep hitting you for one. That's a lot of arrows. There we go. That was lucky timing. Just when I ended my roll, he was able to drop his guard. Knight Helm and a Titanite Chart, and we got an Estus back. Can't complain. There's an item here, so we're going to go for it. Oh, jeez. I thought we'd be okay there. Ooh, we got to be careful, though. All it takes is one bad move in this game to pay for it. But here we go. Got another item that we can sell for some souls. Broadsword. This area is kind of tough to approach. Let's see what we can do. Let's go down here. This would be a great place to use firebombs, but we're not going to use items. Only the bow. So, let's pick this up, because this is another good item to sell, the Astora Straight Sword, which is usually my item of choice in all my characters, for early game at least. It's just got low requirements, easy to use, and does a ton of damage. We're going to cheese these guys a little bit, if we can. Can we? Can we cheese them enough? I only have 16 arrows, this is a bad idea. Okay, well, let's work on getting over here and getting this. I have to start making some decisions here. Oh, well. Him falling down makes my life a little bit easier, I think. Actually, no, it doesn't. Unless he'll blow himself up by throwing those firebombs. Nope, he's destroying the barrels. Alright, well, he's dead. So, we're gonna have to just be crazy with our dodges, because I want to grab that item, and an item behind those boxes. Can I destroy those with an arrow? Alright, that's perhaps useful. Alright, ready folks? We're gonna go in. We're gonna Goomba Stomp and go for it. Come on, Dougie. Sell key. That's what we wanted. Couldn't Goomba Stomp ourselves over here. Can't forget this item. Broke through the tables. I got the shard. Got the doggy on me. There's a thing in here we want. Got that. Dodge the doggy. Dodge the axe. That was not a dodge of the axe. If I had dodged slightly more to the left, I would have gone straight through the barrels and been totally fine. But that's how the cookie crumbles sometimes. So let's make our way back. I'll see you guys there in a second. And we're back here where we first died. My souls, I discovered, are down underneath that table. But we do need to deal with this guy, because he'll blow the crap out of us if we try and jump down there and get our souls without having him throwing bombs at us. We're still going to jump down there and just go for it. Maybe I could get this dog first. That would be nice. Because I do need to defeat these enemies at least once to show that we could do it. There's another area we could fight them, but why not do it here? So let's just go for it. Gotta get our souls first, though. There we go. Alright, let's move to a better area. And, yeah, let's fight them both at the same time. Let's just do that. Why not? Oh, well, that's why not, actually. Wow, we took a lot more damage than I was expecting. Okay, oh, late dodge, and we're dead. I'll see you again, folks. And we're back again with one more attempt at getting through this ridiculous area and keeping my souls the whole time. So, I basically took care of the firebomb guy, and we're back in the exact same situation that I died in last time. So, let's try and just not die in this situation this time. That's basically all we have going for us. Holy smokes! That guy did the biggest flying axe attack I've ever seen in my life. Well, that's that again. We're not quite ready to fight two of those guys at the same time, I think, so I'll see you in a second. So instead of running around and dropping down behind them like last time, I came down and just ran past the knight with the giant shield and sword, and we're just gonna deal with these guys and make our lives a lot easier. That way we can fight one of those guys at a time and move on, so we're not just getting our butts handed to us over and over. Thankfully, we can shoot arrows faster than that guy can throw bombs, but we get a shield here. We're not going to use that. We'll probably end up selling it for arrows as well. But let's see. Can we get the dog? Can we get the dog first? Nope. Oh, this is all right. We didn't get the dog at the same time. I was worried about that. Ooh, we stopped him from doing that crazy leap attack. See, normally this guy with those giant repeating overhand swings can be really tricky and annoying, but with the bow, he's actually not too bad, as long as you don't let him hit you. But that kind of goes for either side, because he can just decimate your health sometimes. Let's see. The dog is still over there, so let's see if we can pull the dog. Because having the dog running around doing his crazy stuff when we're trying to deal with other guys, it's gonna make our life a lot more difficult. With a good shield, the dogs aren't too big of a deal, but we don't have one, so I'm a little worried. Got a good pull on that guy. I'm gonna let him do his attacks and try and do the long range attacks like we were doing on the first boss, Gundyr. Just try and do long range steady attacks and watch out for the big pokes. And try and gain some distance when we can. But when you gotta fight in close quarters, you just gotta know your timings, that's all. Oh shoot, and we don't know our timings at all. Nice, that worked out. When you don't have a lot of room to kite, it makes little things a little bit difficult. So we don't have to fight that guy, because we already killed one. I don't really want to fight him, so we're just gonna move on. We already got the key, so we're good in that department. We do have to fight this guy down here, so let's kill his friend here first. Oh man, that hurt. Please don't sneak up behind this giant scythe wielding, or is it a glaive? It's more like a glaive, I suppose. Oh man, this guy might not be too bad as I die to him. And he might also be horrible. He has a lot of attacks that are just nasty. I like putting him in the fire there. And takes a bunch of extra damage. Ooh, that did way more damage than I was hoping. Alright, let's move on. Let's try and maintain a nice strong distance here. And keep rolling. Keep rolling, rolling. Get some distance. As long as we stay really far away and play really careful. We have plenty of arrows. Should be in the bag. As long as I'm not reckless. Which I tend to be when I think I have things in the bag. Come on, one more shot. There we go. Oh, that was tense. Got an ember. I think there's another ember on this side too. And we got a sword down there called a rapier, I think, that we can sell for some more souls. I wonder if any of you guys want the items that I'm picking up, I'm willing to trade you for arrows. Sorry, we had a little massive FPS dip there for a second. Not sure what caused that. Just went down to practically zero for a moment there. We hardly have any health left, so I am going to pop an ember. If we get invaded, then we'll deal with it. But I just need the health in order to deal with these crossbow guys. In what I feel is a safe manner. Because they can just win the trades. Well, not really win the trades, but when they damage me, it affects my whole adventure. When I kill them, they're just NPCs. So it's a lot better for me to not take damage than for them to not take damage. Alright, so we'll pull this guy by himself. Because dealing with four of these guys at the same time is going to be insane. Right in the face. Damn, that looked painful. But we gotta unlock the shortcut. We need the shortcut. But I want to be able to deal with each event in the game with a bow. And make it like it's like you could actually play the game like this. So I suppose we're actually gonna play the game like this. I imagine it as like if the bow was the only option to play with. Like if the game was just like called Dark Bow Souls or something. And it's like this is the game we designed. You only get to use this. Alright, we took him out. That was scary, but not unbearable. We have a ladder here. And we actually have a decent amount of souls. 2,400, that's... I mean, we've spent probably a good 500 souls on arrows or so, just in the making it through this area. That's not bad. Got the shortcut. And we're going to run past these guys, because I don't want to deal with them right now. And we're actually going to try and make it to the longbow right here, since we're right beside it. And we might as well try. Except we might lose our souls if we screw it up. So hopefully we don't. Longbow and some standard arrows. Dodge that guy and the dogs. If we can make it back without taking a hit from the dogs, then we should be okay. Oh, yeah. What did I say? Alright, well, we're gonna run our way back and do all this stuff and get our souls. But we'll see you guys next time for the next episode of Let's Play Dark Souls 3 with only the bow. Thanks for joining me, and see you next time. Bye for now.